Cold Heart. Who would have thought Elton John would be in the charts once again with a number one song right around the world, mashing up a couple of his more famous songs, including one of my least favourite ones, which was Sacrifice. Rocket Man's pretty good though. But anyway, hey, let's see how it goes. I think it's pretty clever and it's got a smoking bass line. So let's get into it. So first thing that everybody can play, no matter where you're at, is this. There's this little note right at the start. It's this little high synthesizer note. Now, you could play it right up in the 18th fret if you want to, if you've got electric guitar. Now, of course, if you haven't got an electric guitar, that doesn't matter because you can just play it down here in the 6th fret. And that just sort of runs right through the start. Now, if you haven't, this song needs a capo. If you haven't got a capo, you can still play a basic version of it like this. So you go. Just like that. Okay, so let's just go through those notes. So we're just going, but everyone can have a go with this. I'm going to go 6th fret on the E string. I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Cool, and then we're going to jump up to the 6th fret on the A string. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then we're going to go down to the 2nd fret on the E string, and we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Same thing, 1st fret, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is just the basic version if you're a beginner and you just want to have something to play along to. Let's see how that would sound if we play along with it. Alternatively, you just go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, etc., etc. All right, piece of cake. All right, so let's have a crack at the main part, which is the capo chords. Right, so the first chord we're going to do here is an A minor. Then we're going to go into a D minor. Without a tune there. Into an F major 7th. And an E minor. That's better. I've been playing this guitar for months. Alright, okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to play an A minor. So we're going to take our index finger. And that's going to go 1st fret on the B string. Middle finger is going to go, we're going to, let's pretend this is we're playing without a capo, so we're going to call this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That way it's easier than calling out the actual frets. Alright, so of course, fret number 1, index finger, B string. Ring finger is going to go 2nd fret on the G string here, and your middle finger is going to go 2nd fret on the D. And we're going to strum it like this. 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and if you can, try not hit the E. 2 and 3 and 4 and piece of cake. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to go to D minor. Now, just reminding you guys, all the music for this will be at the end of the video. D minor, we're going to go index finger 1st fret, middle finger 2nd fret on the G string, and ring finger 3rd fret on the B string. And we're going to go 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and piece of cake. You could play a bar chord if you want to. We just keep these open chords. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and then we're going to go to an F major 7. So F major 7 is 1st fret B string, 2nd fret G string with your middle finger, 3rd fret D string with your ring finger. And that's going to be strummed out too. You could alternatively play an F bar chord if you wanted to. But F major 7 sounds quite nice. And the last one is E minor. So we're just going to take these two fingers, 2nd fret on the A, 2nd fret on the D, and we're going to go 1, and 2, and 3, and 4. Piece of cake, piece of cake. Cool. So we've got 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and into D minor. Cool. And then to F sharp minor. F sharp major, so F major 7th, E minor. Cool. All right, so let's see how that sounds. So the whole idea is we're just going to keep our right hand here moving through the whole time. Okay, right, so let's just show you how that looks. And that is literally all the chords for the whole song. But we're going to come back and have a look at the bass line after this. Okay, so as you can see, that is really straight ahead and really quite easy. Now, let's have a look at this bass line, which is pretty cool. So we're going to leave the capo on for this. Now, this first bit goes... Right, so let's go through these. So we're going to go open A string first. And if you want to kind of make it sound a bit more like a bass, you could palm mute down here, put your hand up just sort of on the edge of the strings here. So it's a bit dead. Or you could actually play it on a bass too. Right, so we're going to go open A string first. Then we're going to go 2nd fret on the G and play another A note. Then we're going to go directly above it to an E note on the D string. So we've got... And then we're going to go for an open E. So we've got... Sounds like We Are Gone by the Madden Brothers a bit, doesn't it? So, bass line all together. Then we're going to go to the next note, which is the D bass line part. So we're going to go up the 6th fret here, and we're going to go. So we're going to go 5th fret on the A string. Then we're going to go 7th fret on the G. And then 7th fret on the D. And then 2 open A's. So it's... So we've got... Which is quite cool. Cool, just working with roots, octaves and fifths. Then we're going to move down to our F, which goes like this. Sorry, pardon me. So for this one here, we're going to go 2 on the 1st fret, which is your F. Another 2 Fs here in the 3rd fret on the D string. 2 Cs in the A string. And then 2 A strings open. So we've got, and don't forget, all this music is going to be at the end of it. And the last one, we're going to go down to our E, which goes, so that's open E, 2nd fret on the D, second fret on the A, then open E again. So that's the only one that actually returns back to its root note. So in total, we've got this. Whoops. Whoops, did it again. Cool, so the bass line is actually holding a lot more of the groove together in the whole song. So what I'm going to do now is just go through over all the little parts. So each one of these can run over. You can even play this. Right over the whole song if you wanted to. So let's go. So we've got three parts here. Let's start off with the chords. Actually, let's start off with a little high part and then we'll bring in the chords. So here comes the whole song. So feel free to play along. Might just turn that up a little bit. Fades out. Okay, here we go. Cool, so that's how the bass line goes. Straight back to the chorus. Peasy. So that is the whole song, very, very straight ahead, a nice little strummer and a couple of little bits to do. For you advanced students, probably have a bit more of a go on the bass line and get those nice little snappy notes. Whoops, let's do it again. Awesome. All right. So that is the whole song. Enjoy it. And we will see you next time on Heath Watson Guitar.